We think of our solar system as a simple collection of planets and a central star. But it is much more than that, with characteristics as unique to each planet and object as we find with people. Many solar system studies tend to focus on things like distances to the sun, planetary diameters, and each object's rotation and revolution periods. Yet the more fascinating characteristics are what is similar and what is unique for each planet, not how far it is from the sun. You can look that information up in a solar system data table. We classify our solar system's planets in two or three groups. First are the rocky or terrestrial planets, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Next are the gas giants or Jovian planets, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Finally, we have the dwarf or icy planets like Pluto, Ceres, and Eris. The characteristics of each are interesting. We call this comparative planetology. Let's start with the rocky planets. They each have a solid surface, are relatively small in size, and show lots of impacts over the eons of existence. The gas giants have no surface visible. Some suspect that at best, they have a small solid core. These worlds have short rotations, lots and lots of satellites and rings. Dwarf planets are a relatively new classification. Think of very small worlds, smaller than our moon, and in the case of Pluto and Eris, icy, icy worlds. Let's now look at one specific characteristic we can compare for all three groups, atmospheres. Planets like Venus and Mars have carbon dioxide-based atmospheres. This is heavier than our atmosphere and can vary from the extremely thick atmosphere of Venus to the extremely thin atmosphere of Mars. Earth has an atmosphere primarily composed of nitrogen with oxygen and carbon dioxide. The gas giants have atmospheres made up primarily of methane, ammonia, hydrogen, and helium. Think of methane as a swamp gas and ammonia as that nasty smelling liquid that can be used to clean floors. The ratios of these gases vary slightly from gas giant to gas giant. There are also other components. One other interesting characteristic of the gas giant or Jovian planet atmospheres is how fast they spin. This produces interesting swirls and eddies in their atmospheres, which astronomers call belts, spots, and festoons. Jupiter in particular has an incredible set of atmospheric features, including one called the Great Red Spot. How great? 2 times the size of Earth. We are still learning about all of the dwarf planet characteristics, but we know they are relatively small. We suspect all will show evidence of impacts, but have yet to collect good spacecraft images. Two of these dwarf worlds, Pluto and Eris, have moons. Pluto apparently has at least 5 moons, and Eris has 1. Back on Earth, one major characteristic of our planet is that water covers well over 70% of our planet's surface. Arthur C. Clarke said it best, "How inappropriate to call this planet Earth, when clearly it is ocean." We are finding water in many unexpected places in our solar system, but none like the quantity that we find on our home world.